Item number, SCP-230. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-230 is kept in a secure room in sight. The room must have a controlled ventilation system, so that air exiting the room can be properly filtered before it re-enters the regular ventilation system of the complex. SCP-230 is to be given anything he requests that does not violate standard procedures for SCP containment. The door is set to automatically lock every time it closes, and can only be opened from outside the room. Personnel entering SCP-230's room must wear a full hazmat suit with its own oxygen supply. Personnel exposed to the air in SCP-230's cell, or who come in physical contact with SCP-230, or any of SCP-230's bodily fluids, must be contained and held for observation for no less than 1 month. Personnel still exhibiting symptoms from SCP-230 after 1 month are to be terminated. If personnel are cleared by on-site staff after a month, they are then to be transferred and forbidden contact with SCP-230. Due to recent events, subjects that have been exposed and cleared by staff are required to undergo regular psychological exams. If upon exam the personnel exhibits any of the traits shown in document 230-4436B, the personnel is to be terminated. Note: subject has made several escape attempts utilizing personnel exposed to SCP-230. This represents a low threat due to the fact that exposed personnel are usually impaired. However, personnel will become violent in order to stay in SCP-230's presence. Description: SCP-230 is a male Caucasian with a lean build and gaunt appearance. SCP-230 is 185 centimeters, or 6 foot 1 inch tall, 68.04 kilograms, or 150 pounds, and appears to be in his early 30s. He wears bright clothing and prefers the colors pink and yellow. SCP-230 is a very cheerful individual who appears to be incapable of negative emotions. SCP-230 secretes a chemical similar in composition to heroin from his pores. The chemical has been named compound. Once secreted from his pores, it evaporates immediately and contaminates the air around SCP-230. Compound seems to be effective in as little as 30 parts per million in gaseous form. When inhaled, compound causes extreme euphoria in subjects. Analysis on Class D personnel under the effects of SCP-230 indicated they had dopamine levels greater than 5 times of what is expected during sexual climax. Subjects express impairment similar to the effects of heroin. Subjects become willing to comply with any request SCP-230 makes, provided it does not involve leaving SCP-230's presence. Compound is present in all of SCP-230's bodily fluids. Exposure is possible even by contact with SCP-230's skin. Exposure to the compound will result in immediate addiction. Withdrawal symptoms are extreme and have a 30% mortality rate. Symptoms include loss of appetite, tremors, panic, vomiting, diarrhea, irritability, dementia, insanity, blindness, and hemorrhaging. Those symptoms vary from subject to subject. Symptoms typically last for around 2 weeks before subsiding. The symptoms appear to be determined by how much of compound the subject is exposed to. Subjects that ingest any of SCP-230's bodily fluid, i.e. saliva, blood, etc., have a mortality rate from withdrawal of 100%. SCP-230 was found in an apartment in with 20 people acting as his servants. SCP-230 seemed to be actively attempting to limit the number of people he exposed. Several bodies of exposed persons were found on the premises. When questioned about them, SCP-230 replied, "Things were getting crowded, so I had to ask a few of them to stop breathing." SCP-230 appears to be under the effects of compound, but doesn't seem to be impaired by it in any way. Attempts to alter SCP-230's mood have proven ineffective. Use of various drugs known to cause depression only resulted in SCP-230 producing more of compound, and thus were ineffective. SCP-230 is a very friendly individual, and will candidly engage in conversation with any personnel. SCP-230 is unaware of how or when he began secreting compound. When questioned about his past, SCP-230 replied that he has been secreting compound as long as he can remember. SCP-230 prefers to talk about things he considers good or gay. SCP-230 has some psychological attachment to the word gay. When asked to describe himself, SCP-230 used the word gay 6 times, gayety 4 times, and the word gayest once, when SCP-230 referred to himself as, quote, the gayest man alive. Note by Dr. SCP-230's preoccupation with the word gay has nothing to do with sexual orientation. SCP-230 doesn't appear to have a sexual orientation, due to a lack of interest in sex entirely. This makes sense, seeing as SCP-230 experiences the same amount of pleasure doing any given activity, making sex unnecessary. Addendum 231. A Class 2 personnel researcher was accidentally exposed to compound during research. Subject was detained and sent to treatment for the duration of withdrawal symptoms. After 1 month, subject was released after being cleared by medical staff. 2 months later, subject was found trying to break into SCP-230's containment area. Subject reacted violently and injured several personnel before she was detained. Subject was terminated after examination, and precautions have been made to prevent further occurrence. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-229, Wireweed, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.